got a good matchup in store, as it'll be the San Francisco 49ers taking on the Arizona Cardinals. Are over. It's now a four-week sprint to the finish, and we are underway here in week 15. No run back here on the opening kickoff, as we'll start at the 25. Now Purdy finds Gray on the comeback route. Yeah, he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. A good start offensively. 15 yards on the game's initial play.
Play action here on the first play from scrimmage. They want to see how the linebackers are going to react. Are they looking to stop the run? Or are they going to sit back in coverage? A really nice job there of going in attack mode early. And they pick up a quick first down.
And he'll run straight into a wall of tacklers at the line of scrimmage. It's second down. Well, remember, these two teams met earlier in the year in Santa Clara with the Niners coming out on top. So a win here in Arizona would give them the season sweep. Another run with McCaffrey on second down. And some space here. And strong running there as he's across midfield and down to the 49. Now, after all of this, hang on here, because he appears to be shaken up. Well, now they're going to come out and take a look at this injury, and we'll be back in a moment. So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Throwing here, Purdy. Oh, his first throw of the game, going to be intercepted. He's to the 15, and they will score. It's a pick six for the Cardinals' touchdown. How big is that penalty? Wipe out the INT.
You'd hate to be the teammate that caused that penalty and wiped out the interception. You got to face that guy in the locker room. Not a lot of fun for you, and you hurt your squad.
After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's first and 10. Here's Purdy. The Cards get to him here. He's brought down for a sack. B.J. Ogilari getting in there and dropping him. Tell you what, he did not have much time there to skim the field before he was ducking and covering.
Did it appear to you, as it did to me, that the defensive front won their play really quickly, meaning the guys in front of them had almost no chance to block them? They were on him in a hurry.
Now Purdy drops this underneath. It's Mitchell, and he's going to be down at the 35. Gain of 7. This defense for the Cardinals very strong in that victory a week ago.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. Very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground.
Touchdown, 49ers! Brandon Ayuk with touchdown number 12 on the year. And the 49ers are on the board first here this afternoon. Well, Charles, he's still a young signal caller in this league, second year in the NFL. And I don't know if last year as a rookie, if he would have worked through his progressions like he did on that touchdown pass.
I think you're right about that. We're seeing him grow up right in front of our eyes, because when he went to his primary read, he recognized that they were all over that. So he continued to survey the field, picked up another target, delivered a pass exactly where it needed to be. A very mature play for the second-year quarterback.
Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. Oh, the return is Jones from the end zone. Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10, just shy of the 30. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. That whole thing was thrown off track thanks to the defense of Fred Warner. Really nice play. So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. Out of the gun, here's Murray. This is taken in by McBride. A game of 28 yards there and give him the first down.
For a tight end, he's got good straight line speed, and on that route, he's often the guy that gets overlooked. Nice job there finding him in stride for really good yardage.
First down, Murray. Catch is made by Marquise Brown. They'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. That's now a pair of explosive plays in succession, both north of 20 yards. On first down, Merritt. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. The Cardinals at 5-8, three games under 500, and they come in off the extended break from the bye.
And I think it was much needed as well, because you play two and a half months. You know you're ready for some time off in order to get prepared for the home stretch. In fact, when they looked at the schedule to start the season, I think they liked where their open week fell.
And head out of bounds inside the 10, marking down at the 9. 50 catches for him now on the year, and he's got a first down.
And no question, this is exactly how they wanted to start this football game. And nice pass there. Now they're set up beautifully, Charles, to finish this off with a touchdown.
Yeah, but they've still got to finish it off, partner, and that means they've got to execute at this stage of the field. So we've seen many teams marching right to the goal line and not cash in. They've got something dialed up here that puts it in the end zone.
Another shot from the 9 on second and goal. Now Murray, he bootlegs it, sliding out of the pocket. That's complete, right around the 8. Only able to pick up 2, and that leads us to third and goal. He was out there waving his arms, and when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
Murray now, third and goal. Touchdown, Cardinals! A 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Cardinals are an extra point away from drawing level. Extra point good by Brader. And we are tied at 7. They kick it away. Fair catch going to be taken, and this will be moved out to the 25. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up 6 the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated. They both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. Purdy from the gun. Gets this one to Juszczyk. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. 2 yards the loss, and now they go from second and two to a tough third and four.
I think he tried to fool him on that one. You know, being able to throw the ball to the fullback position, no one was fooled on that play.
No, lost yardage. You think they should yank that one from the playbook, at least for the time being?
I think what you do is you take it out and you evaluate it next week in practice.
These two teams all tied after one. The 49ers with the football here to begin the second quarter as they've got it with a third down coming up. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Purdy from the gun on third down. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. Give him 30 yards there.
Despite writing it down on my notes, I never give enough credit to the offensive line, and we have to here. The protection, that's what made this play a success. Quarterback had to wait for his crossing route to develop, and that takes a little bit of extra time. Excellent job by the big fellas up front.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Purdy now to throw off the play action. Over the middle, he's got Gray. And they move this all the way down to the 9. Back-to-back plays of right around 30 yards, and the field position has totally been flipped. Now, we know this offense has the potential to strike quickly, and they just bit off 2 huge plays on back-to-back snaps.
So on the other side of the ball, you've got to go Band of Brothers thought process. No one left behind, no pointing fingers, no accusations, because if you don't, those quick strikes we just saw, they become long-lasting.
The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. They'll run with Mitchell. He pushes forward from maybe 3 down to the 6-yard line.
That's good power football on first and goal. A lot of teams will throw from there, but that's a nice job to chew up a few more yards and get yourself closer to the goal line.
The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. Once more with Mitchell. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Elijah Mitchell, his third rushing touchdown of the year. And the 49ers have now taken the lead. Moody good with the extra point. And that makes the score 14-7. Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. Here's Jones to bring it out of the end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And they enter play here in this one on a 2-game win streak, plus they come off the open week as well. So this is a team that has a lot of things working in their favor.
Oh, it certainly is, and let's face it, this team is playing so well. The worry now is that after a few extra days off, they'll be sluggish coming into this game. So I've heard that he spent more time in practice working what they call good versus good, starting offense versus starting defense. They want a fast start in this next game.
They're going to be stopped up on this first down run. He might have gotten back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it. Here's second and 10.
play action. It's Murray. And just not enough on the throw there. Down around his feet and incomplete. But prior to that, he had hit his first six passes to start the game, so on a nice little run to begin.
It feels like this offense has carried its dress rehearsal into the game. You know, because you do practice it, you do go through it, and in this case, it is clicking exactly like they drew it up.
Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 28. That one goes for 29 yards on third down. So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 as they've got it to the 28-yard line. Now a give right side, Merritt. And some determined running there as he'll pick his way down to the 12-yard line. This game not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. To throw, it's Murray. And he's wrapped up. Taken down, back at the 25. Nick Bosa, make that now 8 sacks for him on the season.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
Oh, it's intercepted. A drive killer there. It's Jair Brown who's got it. And the Niners are going to take over a couple of yards shy of midfield.
And that's what we've seen from this defense all year long, because they've been so good at finding ways to take the football away. And they just gave us another example right here. A strong defense, that's something you're going to need to rely on come playoff time. And this crew has got one. There's no doubt about that, Brandon.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. They start near midfield following the interception as they begin first and 10. Pressure comes and the Cardinals bring him down. It'll be a loss of 7 on the sack, and it brings up second.
Chalked that one up to bad acting, I guess, because they certainly failed to sell the handoff and the pressure stayed keyed in on the quarterback. No Oscar awards for this offense, just a loss of yardage.
On second down, here's Mitchell. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. The Cards going nickel. An extra defensive back out there now on third down. Back to throw, Purdy. They do get 18, but even that won't be quite enough. It's fourth down.
That's the first time he's called his own number, but he's got to be overjoyed with the results. He wasn't just going to settle for a modest game. To me, he was determined to come through with a big message to a defense that slept on him in the pocket.
So on trots the field goal unit, and wow, this is going to be a challenge here. They spot it on the midfield stripe, so it is a 60-yard attempt here. And he's going to miss this one. Wide to the left for distance. It's no good, and this will remain a one-touchdown game.
I don't care who you are. 60 yards is a very ambitious attempt. Hard to make even in practice in the best of conditions. And now, worst of all, you have the other guys involved to start their drive in midfield.
And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. Throwing now is Murray. A short one here, caught by McBride. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. A gain of 10, first down, Arizona. Now Murray. Can't get away, and he's taken down. Cardinals got to go quickly, hustling to the line. Throwing on second and long. Murray. He's got McBride here over the middle. Touchdown, Cardinals. Trey McBride, 43 yards. And the Cardinals are an extra point away from tying the ball game here in the final minute of the first half.
For a big tight end, he can sure move like a slot receiver when he gets ahead of steam going. And as a defensive back, you've got a big decision to make when he's moving like that.
Prater for the extra point. And that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Eluding the pressure right. He'll fire this deep for Ayuk. And this is incomplete. Oh, it looked like he had a pretty good line on that, but that would have been a big play. But he could not pull it in.
And that is not what you expect from a receiver of his caliber. Sometimes you get a little ahead of yourself. You don't hook it in, and all of a sudden it's off the ground. A surprise to all.
He'll fire this deep for Ayuk.
Trying to make every possession count. They took the big shot there, but it winds up incomplete.
On the return, Dortch. It's a 42-yard punt, but 8 on the return. And there'll be time for maybe one final play before halftime. A final shot before half for Murray. This will be caught downfield by Moore. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. We welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. On the return is Jones from the end zone. And all in all, a pretty solid return. Nearly got it to the 35. They'll mark him down officially at the 34. And we're going to stop play here, at least momentarily. It looks like there is a 49er who's in some discomfort. Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. This offense ready for the first drive of the third quarter. Well, quarters number 1 and 2, entertaining. We saw some good offense points put up, Charles, and all tied on the scoreboard.
And it sets us up for what could be a really fun second half, because we've seen both sides score almost at will here in the first half. And now, here in the second half, getting the ball first, you've got to think, hey, we can go out and really run our offense the way we did in the first half. But if I'm a defensive player, all I'm thinking is, can I make a play to really help out my team and break this streak of offense?
And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Moore, the man in motion. Murray going to try to throw on third down. Flush to his right. A gritty play there. Put his nose down, and got his a first.
He's been patient this entire game, waiting for the perfect moment to surprise him with a quarterback keeper. There he catches him off guard and converts his first rush of the game into a first down. Gotta love that efficiency.
Now Murray off play action. And quickly, he just gets that ball out of there. Not quite sure what he was doing, and here comes the flag.
Yeah, he hadn't gotten far enough away from the pocket to throw that football away, and that draws the flag.
Yeah, the old tackle box, right? Get outside of each tackle, and then you can go ahead and throw it away, and you're in good shape. But if you're back there in the pocket, you got to make sure of what you're doing.
Now a throw here to his running back. Fighting his way through contact and past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Without the previous penalty, that would have been a first down. Instead, it's just a gain of 10.
They need 12 here. It's third down.
Well, you got to think, Charles, that one's on the quarterback because everybody was up at the line of scrimmage. He just didn't call for the snap in time.
Yeah, I think he needs a little bit better awareness out there because you got to know when the clock's in single digits and either snap it or get a timeout called if you have one.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. All right, rifles one, that's going to be intercepted. It's Jair Brown who's got it. And the 49ers are going to get this back to their own 34-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
Here's Mitchell now to kick off the drive. There he goes, left side. Now he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A big run there, 29 yards and a first.
At halftime, you had to feel like the defense had to be in a good position. They had to feel good about themselves. They'd had this guy boxed in all game long, but after that run, that might be the breakthrough that he's looking for. Now they may have some difficulty dealing with him the rest of today.
And he'll be brought down just outside of the 30.
44 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame.
But no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
From the 31, here's second down and three. Shotgun now with Purdy.
And he's going to go down. They get to him back. At the 40.
Loss of 10 as multiple defenders get to it.
The passing game's been struggling a bit today, and that was the latest example. Haven't been getting much yardage out of it, and now on his back after the last play, he faces third and long.
Purdy with it on third and long. And he's caught down inside the 10. And did he get in? Down at the 1 yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
And the offense is saying to itself right now, if only they were all this easy, because he was wide open. And once he made the catch, plenty of room to work his way downfield. That was a breakdown on the defensive side of the ball, one that they want to fix immediately.
Purdy will set up to throw it here. Touchdown! Brandon Ayuk with his 13th touchdown of the year and second of the game. And the Niners have moved out in front. A nice throw there by the second-year quarterback.
And I don't believe that was the kind of play he would have made as a rookie, because usually your rookie season is a continuation of your college days. A lot of one read, and if you don't have it, you just take off and go. Now he's settled in the pocket a little bit more, reading the field and getting to a second and sometimes third progression. That was a nice play.
So after the made field goal by Moody, he's back out to kick this one away. Here's Jones to bring it out of the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. So now, Charles, this drive maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
Yeah, and everyone goes through this, because even the best in the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, but how you carry yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
Back to the air on second down, it's Murray. And they're able to get this one across the 35. That catch puts him over 70 yards receiving now as he's got a first down. Up the middle they go. Merritt. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42.
That's a really nice tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it, and be frank about it. Most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
Snap comes to Murray at one. He's going deep for Brown. Oh, they've intercepted Murray for the third time. Picked up by Charvarius Ward. And the Niners are going to get it back here just past the 35. Well, that's three picks he's now thrown in this game.
And I know this, the holiday season, because here we are in December. Right, it is the season of giving. Maybe for his own sake after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he threw.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. Second down, here's Purdy to throw. Able to find Gray here. And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. The catch and run going to wind up netting him 33 yards.
Well, as my dad would say sometimes, I'm just scratching my head here trying to figure out what was going on there defensively. How did you lose him in the middle of the field? If you're going to lose a receiver, make sure it's someone on the short side of things, not deep downfield, that can hurt your defense.
And Dominican Sue, unblockable there as he got in there to make the stop behind the line. So a step in the wrong direction. Now they'll look to make amends on second and 14. Purdy. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And the Cardinals have got it. Going the other way. And his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line. The pocket collapsed around him. I know we talk about it a lot, but a QB has to have that sixth sense, doesn't he?
He really does, and I know of one team at one point was training their quarterback with that time frame, and anytime he didn't get rid of the ball within the right amount of time, they would blow a horn or blow a whistle to show him this is what that time is, just what you're talking about, training him to understand this is the amount you have, make sure the ball's gone. Didn't happen in this case.
We're off to the fourth quarter here in week 15. Happy holidays to all. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Ball right on the 50-yard line. Here's a second and 7. Here's Murray from midfield. Looking for his running back, and he's got him.
give him a gain of 5 on the completion. And this will wind up being a 3rd and 3. And Charles, with that completion, I'm told that puts him over 3,000 yards passing now on the campaign.
And Brandon, nowadays your leader's usually closer to 5,000 yards on the year, but still, 3,000 yards, a good season.
From the gun on 3rd down, Murray. He's going to get that to his running back out of the backfield. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. A big 3rd down pickup of 20 yards. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's 1st and 10. Now a handoff up the middle. Merritt. Down to about the 23. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
Here's Murray. Over the middle, complete. It's Wilson. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And now it's 3rd and 3.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes, when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard, your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there is they were able to connect.
They're not out of it yet, but in order to come back, they need to play clean football the rest of the way. He makes the correct read there, passing on challenging a blanket coverage and getting the 1st down with his legs instead.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. 14 yards. And the Cardinals are an extra point away from tying this game here in the 4th. The kick is through the uprights to tie this game, but hang on a second. We do have a flag, and they'll accept that penalty. But this one setting up for a great finish. All tied in the 4th as the kick's away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Going to lead the 49ers to the line, 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him the football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it.
This is caught at the 20. Touchdown, 49ers. Danny Gray, 68 yards. And the 49ers strike quickly to take the lead here in the 4th. Moody good with the extra point. And they will take a 7-point lead. So following the touchdown, here's Moody back out to send it away. Oh, the return is Jones from the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. And now, after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this 4th quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. Javon Hargrave, the former Eagle, there on the stop. Ball on the 27. Here, 2nd and 6. Murray now to throw. A short one here, caught by McBride.
They call his number again. It's his sixth catch and a first down.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. That goes for 14 yards. First down, Cardinals. Murray going to throw. Throwing for the out route. He finds Wilson. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Murray to air it out again. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Moore. Touchdown, Cardinals. One more Moore. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Cards are an extra point away from tying this game here in the final minutes. But we are set up for a fantastic finish now. A fourth quarter touchdown here. We're an extra point away from a tie football game.
And I know they're thinking about possibly going for two, but I'd go ahead and kick this one and just get it back to level.
Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And we are tied here in the fourth quarter. This one setting up for a great finish. All tied in the fourth as the kick's away. The football will come out to the 25 as McLeod will not return it. This is first and 10. They'll start with a run by Mitchell. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they search for a score to break this tie. They'll come up now on second down. Here's Purdy. Looking for Gray, and he's got him. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
Brandon's okay what they're doing right now. Still able to work the middle of the field, but you know sooner or later, they're going to have to stop the clock.
Plenty of time. All three timeouts still remain. Here's first and 10 now. Purdy to throw. Got a man. That's IU. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
Sometimes it's hard to figure, but you can live with incompletions in this situation. You can't live with these short gains that take time off the clock.
You know who loves it? This defense. Second down, 8 yards to go. Throwing, Purdy. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line.
From here on, any score could be the winning one, and he is certainly aware of that. Look at the way he locked in on that marker and made a mad scramble to get to it for the first down.
Here's first down. A shotgun handoff to Mitchell. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this fourth quarter. The clock reading 40 seconds. Here's second and 10. To throw is Purdy. And he fends him off. And this winds up a pickup of 2, maybe 2.5 to about the 39. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game.
This is third and eight. Here's Purdy to throw. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Cardinals' 24-yard line. Very sharp here to start this drive, 3 for 3.
Yeah, I like the way he's running this two-minute drill. Very sharp, very precise in throwing the football.
And now they're going to get the timeout. A huge play, has him in field goal range with a chance to win. So it all comes down to the right foot of Jake Moody. With 3 seconds to go, this for the win. And a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining. So this is certainly a tough test here in the early career of the rookie kicker. He missed his only attempt earlier. This time he's going for the win. And the kick is good. He got it. And it's official now. They're going to the playoffs.
What a finish in this one, Charles. You know, this group, they come in, they have to fight a hostile atmosphere every snap. They get the late score, they get the victory, and that flight home, it's going to be a little sweeter after this one.
And Brandon, just like you, I was fired up for that last sequence. How about that? Wouldn't you have loved to have been in the huddle when they were mounting that game-winning drive? Big-time moment. No one shied away from it. They tuned out the crowd, kept their heads, and executed the way they needed to earn that win.
So for San Francisco, they remain in the hunt for a first round.